Okay, hi guys. I'm sorry if this video is like slightly on an angle. I can tell that it is, but the tripod that I'm using, which isn't actually a tripod, won't stand up any straighter. Anyway, so today is December the 4th when I'm filming this. Not entirely sure when this is going up, but it'll be the 4th or the 5th. And obviously it is getting into winter, so I thought that I would do a winter slash November favourites, seeing as November has just gone. So I'm going to call this my November favourites, but it's just for winter as well. Things that I've been loving recently. I think I did one of these in maybe September, I'm not sure. Don't think it was October though. So let's just roll with it. Okay, so I'm going to start off with beauty. The first thing that I can think of that I have bought recently and really, really liked. I've just realised the window's open. The first thing I've bought recently. Something I have bought recently that I really like is this. This is an MUA eyebrow pencil in the colour blonde. I wouldn't say it's very blonde, to be fair, it's kind of brown. And it's just a pencil which looks like this. I'll do some close-up shots afterwards. Which I really like. I've never been a fan of drawing your eyebrows on or colouring them in, but this is different because this is just really light. It doesn't make them look drawn on or chiselled or fake, and it has this little brush on the end, which is really cute, and I think this really makes it like blend in. So I really like this. This was like £1 or £1.50, and I didn't want to spend a lot on my first eyebrow pencil, but I recommend this if you're starting out. It's very, very good. The next thing, where if you watch my vlogs you'll have seen it, and if you do watch my vlogs, thank you for that, it means a lot. This is an angled brush, which is only from Wilkinson's. Again, I didn't want to buy an angled brush for eyeliner and then realise I couldn't do it or I didn't like it. So I just bought a cheap one and I really like it. So much so that I bought two. But I'm going to show you this one because it's cleaner. I really like this. I use this for eyeliner more than anything because I think it gives you more of a flick and it can make a cat eye look a lot better. Also, it's got a really cute design on it. Been just really liking this. And then the last thing, they're all eyebrow-y related. This is an eyeliner that I got for my birthday that I didn't even look at because I was like not a massive fan of grey, and it came in a set and I was just obsessed with the lipstick. To the extent where I forgot about this, and I found it, and it's a number seven Stay Perfect metallic eye pencil. It's not black, it's grey, and it's in a really weird little like shape like this, and I use this for my waterline, which I think looks really pretty because it's not heavy and black, it's just like a smoky looks like this. Looks kind of black on my hand, but I promise you it's not. It's like metallic silver. I love this. Last thing in the beauty bit, I don't know if you'd class this as like beauty. No, this is hair. This is my hair thing. I love this. I got this in France from H&M, so you can get this in the UK, but this is from French, or was it Belgium? I don't know where I was. I think I was in France. No, I was in France. And I got this. It's one of these little clips like this that looks really cute like that. And I use this for when I'm just like pinning two bits back and like letting it fall down, or putting it in the back of a bow, which can look really pretty, or putting it on top of a ponytail, that can work as well. I wouldn't wear it like here though, obviously, or like that, but it's a really pretty little thing. I think it's really cute. It's quite big, but I like it. Another thing that I think is an absolute must in these winter months is a little tub of Vaseline. I love this. I put this on my lips and my eyebrows every single night because you're supposed to put it on your eyebrows, something to do with colour or growth or something, I don't really know why, but it works. Well, I don't know if it does, but you know. But I think this is really good for not getting chapped lips. You all know what Vaseline is, you probably all have some, but I like it. Another thing that I am absolutely like, this is the best product, this is amazing, right? This is the Kath Kidston, I don't know, hand cream. I've had these for like a year and they come in a little set of three, and they smell so nice, they feel so nice, and they actually work. Like, some hand creams are like sticky and they don't smell nice and they work, or like there's never all three. This has all three and it's tiny, but it comes in a set of three and I love it. Yeah, chapped lips, Vaseline, chapped hands, Kath Kidston. And then the last like body related thing is this, which is a Zoella Blissful Mistful body, I don't know what you call it, body spray? Body mist. It's not a perfume, it's a body mist. But I really like the smell of this. Like, yeah. At first, I was not entirely 100% fond of the scent of the whole range because it's all the same. But then I've decided I do like it and I like it a lot. And this is really like subtle. It's a just a clean smell. It's like really nice. I would recommend this. Also supporting Zoe in the fact that she is amazing and you should buy it. Because who doesn't love Zoe? Okay, going on to some other like random little things that I've been liking is, actually no, we'll do clothes. This top is another thing I've been loving. This isn't my top, this is my dad's top, but it is so cute. Like, it's all wintery and it's like oversized. It is too big for me, but it looks really cute with a pair of leggings or like skinny jeans and winter boots. And it's just a really cute little winter jumper. This is from Asda, so not expensive, but I absolutely love it. Moving on to some home stuff, like not body related. Something I've been loving is this. This is a winter candle holder. And I've got this little candle, which I'm also really liking, which isn't a real flame. You can't see it in the light. I'll do a close up in a minute. But it looks like this when it's in it. And there's two little reindeers. I don't know how well you can see. I'll show you in a second. But I love this. Obviously you can put actual candles in it. Like I've been putting Yankee candles in as well. But I just think this is super cute for winter. Now the next thing is something very random, which I again picked up in France. No, I didn't. Yes, I did. No, I was on the way to France. I was in a service station. This is from WH Smith, which I think is really, really cute. Like some people that I was on the trip with was like, why have you bought that? But I think it's really cute. I've just been propping this against my wall so that it looks like it's on my wall. I'll show you in a second. But this is just a little M, which stands for Molly, if you didn't know my name. But I really like it. And also it looks like Christmas wrapping paper, so I love it at this time of month. It's so pretty. Something else that is really completely random, but I have used every single day since I got it, is this. This is a flask. This is probably the smallest flask you can get without it being like not a flask. It is 200, it doesn't say how much it holds, but I think it's like 500ml maybe, I don't know. And I've been putting coffee in this every single day and bringing it to school, which does admittedly make my bag heavy, but I don't have time in the morning to make a coffee. But bringing it to school in this is literally, because it's still hot at like 10:30 when I've made it at like 7:30. So I really, really like this. This was not expensive really. It was from Asda and I would recommend having a flask if you like warm drinks like coffee, tea. My friends, we sit there, there's a couple of us. There's me that has coffee, another friend that has tea, another friend that takes our chocolate and another one that takes soup, and we're all just sat there with our little... It has a really cute little like pressy thing. And then you pour it in, but it's empty right now. But the last thing that I want to recommend is this. This is Girl Online by Zoe Sugg, whatever you know her as. I'm guessing the majority of you know her from her YouTube channel, Zoella. Obviously, that is where I know her from. This book, I am like so proud of her. I read a headline in a newspaper yesterday where it was like, girl beats JK Rowling or something like that. And usually being... a massive, massive Harry Potter fan, I would not be happy at all that somebody had knocked JK Rowling off the top of the best-selling debut authors list. But it was Zoe, so I'm really, really happy for her. Obviously, I am upset because Harry Potter and stuff, but it's not oversold Harry Potter by any chance. It's just topped the debut authors, so like new authors list. And this book, I'm not just saying that because Zoe wrote it, because when I read it, I forget that she wrote it because I don't think of Zoe as an author, is literally really good. And if I had enough time, I would have just read it by now, like if I wasn't at school. But I am halfway, maybe a bit less than halfway through it, and I am just so proud of Zoe. It is just amazing. The book is amazing, her channel is amazing, her and Alfie are amazing, just everything's amazing. And if you haven't got this book, go and get this book because it is amazing and you're supporting Zoe. And if you buy it from WH Smiths, you have an exclusive chance to meet Zoella. So yeah. Alright guys, so that was it. Sorry if you're not a fan on talky, sitty, downy videos, but I've been wanting to make this for a while and I hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, be sure to give it a thumbs up I'm also sorry about the state of my hair in this video, but I've been at school all day. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed it. Comment down below any video suggestions you want me to do during the winter months, winter baking, winter Christmas tree decorations, or whatever you want to see. I hope you're all having a great December and winter festive time, and enjoyed my previous vlog where I went to London to see the Christmas lights. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it below. And I shall see you on Sunday. Bye guys!